Hey everyone, I'm Char from Char's Fashion Nation, and if you're new here, welcome. If you're a long time person to my channel, well, welcome back. I'm not going to be saying that all the time, because I don't want to feel like I'm in the zombie part of everybody else. So what we're doing today is I'm going to show you how to do an almost blind stitch, or I should say invisible stitch, by doing this by hand. Now make sure that you have your thread that is the closest match to what you're doing. Now I'm retaking up these pants because I didn't get to do the measurement on the person before taking up the pants the first time that I had to retry them on. Well, I'm not picking all that out. No. So what I've already done is, get the other leg here for you, is on this leg, I already did it. So it's already done on this one. So the hem is already done. And these are just, they're comfortable around the house pants. So, and it's for an elder. So, you know, we got to take care of our elders or take care of each other. And that's just how it should go. I'm always saying that, you know, like, be good to other people because karma comes back on you when you're not. And that's still true. So, just basically, take this needle into the back of the fabric, right? Take it into the back of the fabric and then pull it through. What do you get on the other side? That. Oh, it's the best thing ever. And sometimes it'll accidentally poke through, but as long as you have that thread that matches close enough, I don't think anybody's going to be down on the ground examining the bottom of your pant leg just to see where your stitch is. So, again, you know, and make sure your thread's out of the way. Catch an inside fabric. Take it through that fabric, and there you go. And on the outside, easy peasy breezy. And I don't have these turned inside out, but you can turn it inside out if you want to, but I wanted to keep it like this so that I have this to follow on the out. This will be where you want to end that at, and know how much, just like we would on our sewing machines, that's how much of a seam allowance you want to give it in case you need to pick it all out and redo it. That makes sense. It does make sense. So, and then doing this by hand, different than, I can move the camera down for you guys a little. Doing this by hand, opposed to doing this by machine, your stitches are obviously going to be a lot more different, as you can tell right here, that was on the back and the front. So, I did want to show you guys that today. Yes, I will be doing another look tonight. I asked a friend, you know, like, what look she would want me to do. And she's like, Morticia. I'm like, no, I did Morticia last year. And then she's like, oh, I have to go look for that. So she's going to go look for last year's. Now, I never looked over last year's videos to see if there was any strange activity. Because the haunted chair was actually over this way. The desk wasn't here, and the recliner was where this desk is. So, I did move a little bit of furniture around. Just a small bit. Like I said, you know, just take it and you know where your end stitch line is. And this is very easy. I mean, if you watch the other video, so I've answered, yeah, I'll link that so that you guys can just go over there and watch that, because that's about sewing. During the day, you do sewing. At night, this gets scary. I did catch something interesting in yesterday's video, but like I said, we're going to do kind of like an Easter egg and or trick or treat type thing where you have to tell me in several different videos. And I'm not going to make you do a timestamp. If you want to do a timestamp, leave a timestamp. I would say go on to my old channel. Oh my gosh, I have something over there that even Let's Read made a comment about. That creeped him out, and he tells scary stories. Oh my gosh. Let's see. And then I've had Chills narrator playing in the background of one of my older videos on the channel I no longer have access to. I don't want to have to pay YouTube just to be able to just like have them leave that open for me. Although, I have been thinking about that. Do I want to seriously get all that content back? Absolutely. So, we'll see what I can do. But meanwhile, look at that. We've gotten to this point, but look. Serious. It's so easy. If you have to take a pair of pants, make sure that you have a measuring tape available. And I've been thinking about doing this. Like, for those of you that don't have a sewing machine, but you need to sew by hand, I've actually been thinking about putting together like small sewing care packages for some of my viewers that have been on here, and you know, put that together for you. Maybe like a little basket of sewing stuff. If you're interested in that, let me know. I'm not trying to look away from the camera on purpose. I'm looking away from the camera because I'm sewing. And I didn't take too much thread at first to do this, but I did take just enough thread to go from right here to almost all the way around. And then I'll get another length of thread. Oh, that's funny. Another length of thread. And finish this off. And meanwhile, I can still talk to you guys while I'm doing this. This really isn't going to take that long. I did the other one this morning and then started this one. And then I was like, you know what? I need a little break. My back was hurting me. That's common. My back always hurts. That's never going to go away. Yum, yum. But you know what? I'm still breathing. And that's what matters. It is. Because I bring you guys content. And look at that. You really can't tell right here with the stitches. You really can't. Because the thread blends. And that's the wonderful thing about having matching threads to just about every fabric. Like, if you have a thread that's just a little bit off, you may be able to get away with it. I've been able to do that before in the past. Just, like, get away with a thread that's, like, you have a black garment or a blue garment that happens to be a navy blue garment, and all you have is black thread. You can still sew with black thread. It's no big deal. Or if you have the black material, and all you have is really dark navy blue thread, you could probably get away with it as long as it's dark enough. And there's some deep purple threads out there that would work too. But if you want it more where you can see your thread, to make it more a fashion statement, don't go too crazy with the colors. Then some people may think that, you know, something wrong. But, because trust me, I have seen so many garments out there that I was like, who designed that and why were they allowed? Why were they allowed? Because that's loud. Something like this, where you just want to make it like an invisible stitch. This worked out just fine for that. And, back to the trick-or-treat thing. Like, I've been thinking about that. Like, we're going to do, like, this trick-or-treat through my video so that you guys can see how many weird things have happened. Have you heard any weird voices over me? Talking over me. I did catch something from last night, but I'm not going to tell you what it is. I want you to search for it in the video. That yelling doesn't count. That's an actual person. Neither will it count if she goes in her room and slams the door back here. That will not count. You know, it's not the loud ones that you have to worry about. They're just for show. It's we quiet, timid people. Not crazy. So that's called knowing how to handle yourself in a manner of etiquette. So knowing how to handle yourself in a manner of etiquette. That people have no etiquette. I'm not ashamed to say that. Loud people have no etiquette. Okay, I can see if you're deaf and you can't hear too good and you're a little bit loud and you're not aware of it, but, like, just people that do it just to do it, like, freaking please, you have no etiquette. I had to learn etiquette of the ways of the military. Proper speaking, proper hair, makeup, clothing, how to stitch on a patch, how to iron that perfect crease on a military uniform. Mm-hmm. somebody out there had to do that. I've done it. I had to do it when I was a teenager. Let me get a drink of water real quick. So, yes. Now that I had my drink of water, which I always love having water on hand. It's just my thing. I used to drink a lot of soda, but I gave that up. I gave up the soda because the carbons themselves, think about how much carbon is in a soda. And I mean actual carbon base is in a soda. And what the molecules of a carbon from a soda does to the molecules of the human body. Did you know you can clean a stainless steel sink with Coke or Pepsi? It's true, I've done it. I've even cleaned a toilet with that. It works. It does work. And that's only because, like, you know, the hard water that gets in the rural area, and they don't have a really good filtration system, and then you have a problem getting all that out. Look, I don't have much thread left down here, but this has gone almost all the way around. So what I'm going to do is finish this thread and come back with the new thread and thread that in, and then we'll be done with this momentarily. Be right back. So anyway, I've come to the point where I'm going to change out this thread. Get a pair of scissors for that. You know, I still can't find my little red-handled crafting scissors, which is kind of weird. They just poof and disappeared. I have no idea where they went. So, the Dollar General has some interesting spools of thread now. They do have some bigger ones, so I was glad to find these in a package. Well, they actually come in a package of three. So there's also kind of a taupe color, not maybe really taupe. I would say more of a beige tone that comes in it, which isn't bad. I'm not mad at that. Because maybe you have something that's a khaki color fabric and you may need that. It's not labeled by a company on this, but I think the package was labeled, and it's pretty much the same thing that I've been getting with all the other stuff in their store for sewing. So maybe they're picking up their A game on this. We could hope, right? So, I mean, having the bigger spools of thread like that, yeah, that's some A game action right there. Guys are like, oh, you did the grandma thing. I am somebody's grandma. And I'm not afraid to say it. That's right. I'm not afraid to say I'm actually someone's grandma. Okay, just spool that back. I was trying to bring you guys something funny. Maybe a little humor into the video. Nothing wrong with that. Add a little humor to your video every once in a while. Spot here and there. You'll find out how much more people you actually have come and meet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off underneath and then come back. So see, that's the trick to hiding that tail. tail of this. Just take it underneath, tuck it, and it's gone. And then you just pick up where you left off. Just take a bit of the inside material, push it through, and then take it slow when it's like super long, because that's when it can get really tangled, and we don't want tangled thread. We definitely don't want it to be knotty. So when am I going to work with my fabric mark fabric? Well, I have these pairs of pants to finish, which is actually including these. This would be the first out of four pair. So the other three pair I'm actually going to finish on my machine. Now, I started these by hand this morning because I wanted to be nice and not wake everybody with the sound of sewing machine. Wow. How nice of me. Because I did not want to wake anybody else up by being loud. Yeah. Pretty much that's just me. If everybody else is asleep, I won't start up the sewing machine until people are awake. Then away I go. If I know I have something to do, yeah, I just need to get these finished. Winter will be upon us. I have so much to teach you. I have that vest to finish for myself. And then see how it fits. My weight goes up and down, so we'll see. I'm going to keep it. I don't care. It goes with the pants. And what fabrics I have right now are absolutely going to be used up. Now, I found this really pretty faux fur yesterday that looked like real fur. But I just really wasn't going to pay $12 a yard. Beautiful, but $12 a yard, a little much out of my affordability. Otherwise, I probably would have made me a faux fur winter coat and moccasins. You know, got the lining for the mocks and the bottom piece for the mocks, but I figured next month, since next month is my birthday month, I'm just going to treat myself to some biker boots. They have great traction. They really do. And I found two pairs that I really like. And one of them happens to be a pair of Harleys. Now, Adam Sandoval from Adam Sandoval Rides was doing the Bring It Home. Was that yesterday, I believe? And I think he said it was on the 5th. Not he was doing it today, but still, more than 3,000. And some people had registered their Harleys to go on that ride with him to bring home the world record, the Guinness Book World Record. The largest amount of Harley Davidsons ridden. So it's like, that was already in, like, one other country already took that world record for Guinness Book. So it used to be in America, but it was in another country, and then he wanted to bring it back to America, where Harley originated. So, his friends at Paris Harley Davidson in Paris, Texas, were helping him out with that. And I think that's cool. I still wouldn't mind having some of his merch. He has some really cool merch. He even has merch for kids, coloring books and little books to read for kids. It's about Scooter, his dog, his little chihuahua, his little biker chihuahua. apparently does not like other dogs and will not let other dogs near that motorcycle. So whatever motorcycle he's on, rather, is the war horse, which was the first one that they were in an accident. Well, a lady hit the war horse and his leg was all smashed, but Scooter was okay because of the pet palace. So if you ride and you have an animal, look into a pet palace. But just remember to always be safe on that road. There's a lot of crazy drivers out there. They're always on their cell phone, not paying attention. They hit your vehicle, they hit your ride. They drive too fast. Sometimes I wonder what's wrong with those people. Like, what's wrong with them? Life is more important than your cell phone. Now this is turning into a PSA. Kind of funny, it's kind of turning into the PSA. Oh yeah, like when I used to do, what's the name of the clown I used to do? Anyway, Precious the Clown. When I used to do Precious the Clown. Hi, I'm Precious the Clown, bringing you a PSA. Public service announcement, yeah. There you go. Maybe I should just go ahead and do a Precious the Clown look. I'm not into clowns, but I'll tell you what. That's one that I did that actually wasn't creepus. But it might stir up some activity in here that we may not want. I know who they go on. But anyway, those fabric mark fabrics. Oh, and the other fabric called the Ghastly Night. I will be working with that this month. So we'll be doing the 31 looks, but that'll be one of the looks is what I will be making out of that. And Juliet from Crochet Me Too was like pajamas. Nobody else really like gave, you know, a good poll read on what they wanted to see me make out of that material. So pajamas it is. Just make the pajamas so that they're actually just wearable, just like I did the yoga pants. So that they're just wearable. I keep noticing this little globe keeps coming up on my screen when it's saying that there's no internet in here. That's never been there before. Da, da, da. I'm just saying, like, that's just like, okay, here we go. Now, I always take my thread 3 times around, and then I'll pull it and make a knot. And if you want to make 2 knots in there, you do that. If you want to make 3 knots in there, you do that. I'm just trying to make this more secure on the end. That way, when I go to clip it off, here we go. And that's what it's like on both sides. Now, I had to measure these out and then remeasure. And then now this is a 28-inch inseam for the person that I took these up for. Now I'm trying to figure out where these little black marks on the fabric came from. That might have come from the wrong place. But anyway, around the house pants are now taken up at the bottom by hand. And seriously, if you don't have a sewing machine, don't think that you can't sew. Absolutely, you can sew. All you really need is needle and thread, a good measuring tape so that you can measure, because size matters for that. For that, size actually does matter, because you need to measure yourself and you need the tool to do that. So you do need one of these, and this one is a, this is a 60 inch. So I would be able to measure that size for a person. If they just so happen to be that size, it's no big deal. So, the other one thing that I can say is good thread. You really need good quality thread. Now, if you needed to, you could use a bonding tape for your fabric. Make sure you have a good fabric tape that you iron. I will tell you though, if you go to take your needle through it, it's going to be super sticky and going to be hard to sew through even on a sewing machine. Excuse me. So just keep that in mind. And I hope you enjoyed this. This is a sewing segment. So, for Char's Fashionation. So, seriously, taking up the seam allowance again. And then now this will fit proper because I didn't get to measure her proper the first time. So, I'm not mad about that because it's done now. Yay! like I said, if you're in on the looking for the strange paranormal activity in my videos, which I find to be rather fascinating because I've found quite a few lately, but I'm not going to tell you where they are. You have to go look for them. It's going to be fun. You just look for them or listen for them. The only one that's excluded for listening to, like I've said, is the one where I let you listen to the EVPs. Now, unless something else talked over that, then that's different. Or unless something talked over me, then that's different. Now, there is that sewing by hand video that I want you to watch. It's got something in there that you can, what was that? And I already tried to debunk it. I tried my best to debunk it. I filmed at the same exact hour the next day under the same conditions. Nothing. So you have to tell me, what did you see that I may not have? What did you hear? I may not have. Okay, everybody. So until later for that look. Stay happy, stay healthy, stay positive, and as always, stay blessed. And I'm going to try to, for you guys, pull up that strange picture, and then we're gonna talk about that while I'm doing, you know, the look. We're gonna talk about that. Like, what? How the heck did that happen? Huh? Yeah, we're gonna talk about that because I'm gonna try to pull that up today for you. So until later, have a blessed day.